and tags. I think that that's really important because I know that you're going to see it based on the title, not necessarily the tags. Facebook does a pretty good job of grouping things, but not as perfect as you'd want. And so we're definitely live. Okay. All right. The last step is we're sharing the screen. Here we go. Hello, everybody. If you haven't already jumped on, this is my new live today. And I'm going to lower this so that I don't have the share screen getting in front of it. Okay, one thing I wanted to do is I'm actually going to use my Facebook program right here as my whiteboard, as my I'm going to use this today to kind of help you know what my thoughts are. So I'm going to actually write in some things as I go along. And I'm not going to publish this. This is just for your benefit because you're on my live. One of the things that I've found is that there are some specific things you can do right now to be in a good program, to be in the right place at the right time. And it's not what you think. A lot of the time people just gravitate towards a particular product or service and then they ram it around into people's throats everywhere they go, and they think that's going to succeed to get people to join them. And as I'm sure you've heard this millions of times, I'm sure, people do not join opportunities regardless of how good they seem to be. They join people. And there's specific things that you need to know you have in place, and these are the things people want. For one thing, you've got to know that one of the things people question, now I'm going to write it down on this status. I'm not going to actually publish this, but it's going to be in front of your face, and that'll help you out. And one of the things people question, they question two things before they ask anything else. They're asking this inside their head, whether they say it out loud or not. Are people making money at this? That's one of the things they are thinking. Do you know them? Because this is the things I ask myself. Can I get to know them? Ah, come on. And can I do this too? So those are the questions people are asking. Are people making money at this? In other words, when they say something like, is this a scam? What happens usually in a scam? I haven't been in a scam. I never promote scams, but I understand what that question really means. Are real people making money at this? Are real people making money at this? When it's a scam, it's only the person that's offering it and not anyone else usually. And sometimes they have an army of people that think they're going to make money and they're not going to make money because only one person makes money and that's the person at the top. That's a scam. That's a pyramid. That's wrong. That's not generally what is usually around and survives because the FCC is going to get a hold of the people that are doing scams. And those are going to go away. And I've seen a few of those happen. And I usually look at them and go, I see some red flags in this and I don't get involved. So they're asking, are people making money at this? Can I make money at this? Are you making money at this? Do you know these people that are making money at this? Can I get to know them? Are they available to me? Will I be able to ask questions of them? And can I do this too? Think about this. If you understand that these are the questions people are really asking, when they ask the other kinds of questions, like how much is it? Is it free or is there a cost? When they're asking, is there a cost? They're really asking, what is in it for me? Why should I even look at this? Is there a reason why I want to pay money for this? So now let's go down and answer some of these questions. And I can answer absolutely positively to everything I involve myself with, that these answers are yes to everything. What are some of the things people really want to do when they're asking these questions? Will this change my life? Will it solve my problem? Keep hitting the cap. First of all, they have to know what their problem is. What is their problem? Now, when you're offering something that somebody really hasn't thought about wanting, they don't know that it's a problem they can solve. For instance, if you have a wonderful health product that maybe even makes them feel better, helps them get over some of the health problems they have, you know, you can't make absolute claims because you don't know that person and whether they're going to actually take it properly as directed. You don't know if they will stay with it long enough to get the result. So you can't make, that's one of the reasons why they tell you that you can't make health claims, because a lot of the time, people don't realize that it's not going to be instant. There's nothing in the world that's instant. So will it change my life? Will it solve my problem? I always answer, will you stay with it long enough for it to change your life? Will you stay with it long enough to solve your problem? I don't know you. I don't know whether you're looking for something that is not possible, like making a change that's going to solve your problem in one day. Most of the time, your problems didn't happen in one day, so it's not very likely that anything will solve your problem in one day. So here's another thing to think about. Value. You hear this all the time. What is value? Value is giving them something they need for an exchange of money that you need. So let's write that down. What is value? It is giving money for something that they want or need. That's the exchange of value for money. Now, a lot of the time people try to jump around this and do it so fast that they don't see any value, and you tell them right away how they can spend money, but you don't give them any of the opportunities to understand what it is they're going to get and what are they going to get. Obviously, you want them to be able to change their life. You want them to, they'd always want, now remember the question up in the beginning? Do you know them? Can I get to know them? Those are the leaders, the people that are making money, right? Okay, so if they need to make money or learn about these other people, they're really asking about community. Now, one is one of the best ways that they can learn, get together with people. Now, in the old days, network marketing was about network marketing in real life, in a real setting, face-to-face with real people. Now, in these days, we don't necessarily have to offer a real community face-to-face, like meetings every week or whatever. Home meetings have kind of been replaced with meetings that you can do online. And some of the ways that that happens is Facebook groups. And chats and hangouts. And then what is another thing that people really, really, really need? If they're brand new, they need training. This is value that they get, usually for free, as part of being part of your community and your business. These also can even either be created in a live setting where they have to actually go somewhere, or it can be online, which is one of the major ways people do that now. And that can be done right inside the group now these days as well. And so these are some of the things to think about. If you are serious about building a business that actually builds this kind of value for the proposition to that person, and the product itself can save their lives as well. Now, what I've been offering is a product called My Econ, and what it is it's a way to get better at financial side of your business. And I'm not going to demonstrate that today because I have in other videos, but one of the things I tell people all the time, and this really is a value added proposition, is it's not how much money you make, but it's how much money you can keep. If everything that you earn goes out away from you into if it all goes out and away and you don't have it anymore, then it's not valuable to you any longer because you've already spent it. But if there's an opportunity to invest, to save, to have money on hand when something comes up, that is of more value. Obviously, you want to make some money as well, because most people are living right on the edge. But if you make an additional, let's say $500, that's the low end of what a lot of the time companies will promise, that is possible. We're not making a claim that you absolutely will do that, because there's action you must take in order to accomplish that. So, like they always say, we cannot make those kind of promises. It all depends on your personal action and your personal ability. But what if there's other products in the program I'm part of? One in particular, a way to learn how to not only look at your credit rating and your reports, and learn how to actually contest things that are not real and are not true. And there can often be things that are hanging on there that are old and already taken care of in some way. And you can actually get those things off of your credit rating, off of your report. And by doing that, you can actually raise your credit score to a higher number. And the higher you can make it, into the at least 600s, mine are in the 600s, raising it higher to 700. But of course, a perfect credit rating, I think the top number is 850. Many people don't reach that, and that's okay. Because when you have a certain amount of credit you're using on a regular basis, that goes against you in some ways, but yet you have to have some credit you're using in order to have a credit rating. People that just operate from cash only do not have a credit rating, and that actually goes against them. Now, where would it go against you? One of the major things that happens is if you want to have, you know, even insurance these days, they actually do a rate inquiry on you and find out where your credit rating is. And if you're below 600, you're in a bad place. You want to get above that. You want to get in a place where you have a better rate. And another thing that happens is you get offered better kinds of credit, has lower interest rates. And that is why you want to actually succeed to go this route and make a definite, I'm sorry, I got sidetracked because somebody was talking to me over here. But anyway, you want to actually work on getting your credit rating as high as possible, your score. You want to get it as high as possible because it opens you up to opportunities you might not get otherwise. There's companies that won't even do business with you if your credit rating is low or your credit score is low. Renting cars, getting a new credit card or in credit for the purpose of being able to buy a large item, buying a house, buying a car, renting a car, buying a car, travel and sometimes even affects you in that way. You need to have your credit score as high as you can get it. You need to get it to the high 600s or into the 700s at least. And there are ways that you can accomplish that by actually changing your life by getting part of a product. And I have a product, it's less than $50 to get started, and then it's only, I think it's $20 a month, depending on which program you decide to choose. For me, that was a no-brainer, and I'm having a lot of fun learning how to be better at taking care of my money, because it, again, that saying, let me write that down, because I think it's that important, and I'm going to put it in caps. It's not how much you make, but it is how much you get to keep. You should put this saying in your thought process and realize it's not, don't make yourself always think about how much is this, how much is that. But it's how much do you get to keep? How much do you not have to spend in order to have a comfortable, enjoyable life in your circumstances? You know, I'm not one of those people that thinks I have to have a mansion and the most expensive car out there in order to prove who I am. I believe that if I can say I made all of my bills and had money left over to play with, that is what matters to me. And you know what? I bet it matters to you too. Because it's not fun to be in a place where you have a pile of bills and you can't pay them. It's not fun at all. It's not fun to be in a place where you are worried that you're going to lose your house or you're going to lose your job and you don't know where the next dollar is going to come from. You don't know if you're even going to get to eat properly. That doesn't feel good. So it's all about how you decide you're going to take care of it. And you come back to this value. What is your value proposition? Can you answer these questions to the best of your ability to people that want to be in your business, whatever it is? And if you can answer that question without a whole bunch of hype, that would be even better. When you go blah, 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 answering question, you know, and you write several paragraphs or you say it, you've lost that person because you really didn't listen. Don't tell them about all the things you think your product does instead of understanding what their real question is. So the success is giving the money for something they want or need, and they want it bad enough that they don't even think about asking, how much is it? That is a value. That they're starting to see the value of whatever it is and they want it right now. I've had too many people come to me and give me this great big long spiel about their company or product or business, and they didn't even ask me one question about how I am or what I think about what they're doing, about learning about something. They don't ask me any questions. They just give me that spiel, thinking they will convince me to look at it because of their spiel. They've lost me because of that spiel. I never join a business because of that. What I do join a business for is when I see people giving great value and training to others without expecting to get paid for it, And that's why I'm doing what I do too. I want you to understand that people love to know what's going on in your life. And I'll tell you one thing, understanding, I don't need my glasses, I don't take them off. Understanding what people's real questions are, understanding what they're really looking for, and being willing to tell them in a way that they can understand is far more valuable than the great big spiel, because guess what? That's about you, not about them. So I want them to actually see that I'm answering their questions, even if they didn't know they were asking that question. For instance, not always are people really in tune enough with their head to know that they're really asking these questions up here when they say something like, is it a scam? Or, I think that's a scam. They might say it that way too, but they're really saying it that way. They're not getting an answer to these questions when they say that to you. Or if they say, how much is it? Because they're putting their guard up because they don't want to pay for something. Then they're saying, you haven't told me why I should spend my money on that. You've only told me what it is, and you haven't asked me what it is I want before you gave me the great big spiel about it, and probably a link as well. And yes, the link is on this description of my video today, but only because I believe that I've given you enough value that you're willing to go look. And that's how I look at it. I'm going to give you value, and then I'm going to give you just enough information that you will go and look at it. I don't need to give you 50 minutes of spiel about my product or business, because I believe everybody needs to improve their finances. Because you know what? It's really crazy, but you can live with a lot less money than you think you can if you're not on the edge and you don't have absolutely every dime going out, and even a little bit extra, because you end up having that you have late fees and all this other stuff because you can't pay it on time. That is a miserable place to be, and you don't want to be there. And I know that there's far too many people that really are there, and it hurts and it doesn't feel good. And what do you say when people say, I absolutely don't have the money? It's because they put themselves in that place. And I feel really sorry for them. I don't have an answer for them, because there is no way to solve that for them unless they make a decision that they're going to do that. And the way they do that generally is going to be that they are going to have to find it somewhere and not be in such a hurry to say they don't have it. Does that mean people don't have it? Well, the only people that absolutely don't have it are the people that are living on the street and have to beg for money. The ones that still have a job and still have a home and a car, they really do have money. They just might not be willing to part with it. Now, I don't mean thousands of dollars, because nobody really wants to spend that right out of the bat. But I know somebody has $20, and they really do want to change their life. And I've just given you a really good formula on how you can do that. So let me know what you think. Pass this on to others, because I think it's that valuable. And make sure and like and share this video. And also I want to encourage you to actually go, I don't have it where I can go to it. I think I do. Yes, here is the group that I am adding video to every single day. Now I'm on purpose adding old video first. And I'm doing that because I want those things to actually be in there on the bottom of the pile, not on the top. And as we go along and I add those to the folder, you will see that it's going to be worth it to look at that. And it's going to be fun to actually look at where I came from. And there's a reason why I'm sharing that. I believe that you will actually gain a lot from being part of the community I'm building right here. And it's brand new, only had it there a few days, So do add that as one of your communities. Go like it. Go enjoy some of the video content I already have in there. And I'm going to be adding more to it again. And I'm doing these Facebook Lives here on the profile for the purpose of being able to add them back into this video library later. I hope you have an awesome day. I hope you got some value from this. Let me know if you have. And definitely, please, share and like. I'll talk to you again shortly. Bye for now.